Welcome to this presentation on CAN and Flexray protocol comparison. In this video, we will see what are the features of CAN and what are the features of Flexray protocol and how they are different from each other. Okay, with respect to number of lines, CAN is used basically to reduce the number of wires going in and around the vehicle. Let us see the comparison with respect to number of wires the CAN and the Flexray use. CAN uses two wires, which is called as CAN high and CAN low. Flexray also makes use of two wires, which is called as bus plus and bus minus. Okay, with respect to speed, CAN operates at max bit rate of 1 Mbps usually. For most of the automotive applications, the industry don't go for 1 Mbps. Usually they set it for 500 Kbps. Whereas Flexray is 10 times faster than CAN, which has got 10 Mbps max bitrate. Triggering. Okay, the CAN is an event triggered. So if any message to be sent, some event should happen. So it's an event triggered protocol, whereas Flexray is a time triggered as well as event triggered protocol. I will explain you about more about the, why it is time driven as well as event driven in the upcoming slides. Okay, what about the communication architecture? Okay, so CAN is a multi-master network. So there is no master slave network over here. Everybody is master, anybody is free to send data at any point of time. So there is no one master which will control the bus. Everybody is master over here. Anybody has any data to be sent, they can send if bus is free. Flexray is also like a multi-master communication network. Here also you don't have master-slave network. Here also everybody is a master, anybody has data to be sent. They can send the data at any point of time, but when you compare with CAN, Flexray, in the previous question you saw, Flexray has both static segment as well as a dynamic segment. So there is a slot allocated for every node in the static segment. So during that slot, node can send the data, and it also has a optional dynamic segment, okay, where they can compute for the bus dynamically. Okay, bus conflict, as I just mentioned, CAN uses an arbitration process to resolve the bus conflict, whereas Flexray has two different segments. There's a static segment and a dynamic segment. So in the static segment, it makes use of time division multiple access. Okay, a slot is allocated for every node. During that slot, a node can transmit the data. Okay, and there is something called as dynamic segment, where they can compute for the bus dynamically. Okay, so it is called as a flexible time division multiple access. Okay, time division multiple access, flexible time division multiple access. So noise elimination. How noise is eliminated in CAN and Flexray? So both CAN and Flexray both uses a differential voltage logic. Okay, to eliminate the noises. For example, both uses two wires. So if there are noise present on the lines, so when you subtract, so the noise gets eliminated. So that is the reason they make use of a differential voltage concept. What about the hardware redundancy? So in CAN, you don't have any hardware redundant channel. Okay, you will have only one channel, whereas in Flexray you have a redundant channel. Channel A and channel B, there will be two channels. So even if one channel fails, the communication can happen on the another channel. Okay, what about the voltage levels? Okay, CAN protocol makes use of 3.5 volt, 1.5 volt and 2.5 volt. So these are the different voltage ranges for sending resistive and dominant logic in CAN. So if at all, if it's to send dominant, the voltage levels are different. If it has to send a resistive, the voltage levels are different. Even for the Flexray, this also makes use of differential voltage concept. It also has two wires. The two bus levels are data 1 and data 0, which are dominant bus levels. So we will see pictorially how these data are sent or the logic levels are sent on the bus. So you can see this is a CAN bus. So if at all it has to send any node wants to send 0 on the bus, okay, so that is called as dominant. So on CAN high it will be 3.5 volt and on CAN low it is 1.5 volts. So if you take a difference out of it, you will get 2 volts. Okay, so if at all any node wants to send 1 on the bus, then both the lines CAN high and CAN low will have 2.5 and 2.5 volts. So if you take a difference out of this, you will get 0 volts. So for dominant, it is 2 volt and recessive, it is 0 volts. Okay, right. So with respect to Flexray, you can see there are 4 different states of Flexray over here. So if at all any node wants to send a high, that is data 1 on the bus, then the bus plus will have 3.5 volt and bus minus will have 1.5 volt. Okay, it is quite different from CAN here. So if at all it has to send data 0, then bus minus will have 3.5 volt and bus plus will have 1.5 volts. Okay, so here if you take in data 1, if you take differential voltage, you will get 2 volts, whereas here you will get minus 2 volts. Okay, there are another 2 states over here. You can see recessive bus level. This is where when there is no activity happening on the bus. So there is no activity happening on the bus. So bus will be in the idle state. Like no data is sent or received. So bus will be in the idle state. During that time, bus plus and bus minus, both lines will have 2.5 volts and 2.5 volts. Okay, so there is another state over here. You can see recessive bus level during, it is a idle low power. So if transceivers are in the sleep mode, then both will have 0 volts and 0 volts on the bus. So these are the different voltage levels of CAN and the Flexray. Okay, what about the guaranteed latency? How guarantee the data will be sent on the bus? Okay, so CAN makes the lower priority message to wait. Okay, because CAN has got a prioritization in the message identifier. Okay, if two nodes try to send the data at the same time, then that is resolved through the arbitration process. Okay, how arbitration works? Arbitration works based on the message identifier value. Lower the identifier, higher is the priority. Higher the identifier, lower is the priority. That means always the lower priority message has to wait. That is the one of the drawback or a limitation of CAN, you can say. The lower priority message always has to wait. So this is avoided in the Flexray because Flexray has got static segment as well as the dynamic segment. So in the static segment, the slot is allocated for every node so they can transmit the data. And it is predefined during the design phase. This is not dynamic. And it also has a optional dynamic slot wherein they can, any node wants to send the data, they can compute for the bus. Okay, voltage converters. Of course, Flexray and CAN both need the transceivers because if you look at the voltage levels, they are quite different. The voltage levels on the CAN bus and the voltage levels on the Flexray bus, both are of different voltage levels when you look at the microcontroller. Okay, so that is the reason they need a transceivers. Flexray makes use of Flexray transceiver and CAN makes use of a CAN transceivers. They are voltage converters from TTL to CAN bus voltage levels, from CAN bus logic level to TTL and vice versa. So for both CAN and Flexray, both makes use of a transceivers. Okay, let us look at the applications. CAN is basically used for safety critical applications such as ABS, airbag, engine management system, whereas Flexray is much faster than CAN. It is used in ADAS, X-by-wire system, high performance application. What about the start stop bits? CAN uses a startup frame and it has got a end of frame which consists of 7 recessive bits. Flexray starts with there is no start stop bits there in Flexray, but it has got indicator bits when it starts the frame. look at the bus terminating resistor. Okay, why do we need bus terminating resistor? So to avoid the signal reflections and to avoid the noise, we need a bus terminating resistor. Okay, so as per the standard, the CAN uses 120 ohm resistor to terminate the bus at both the ends. Even the Flexray also uses a pull-up resistor about 80 to 100 ohm as a bus terminating resistor. Okay, what about the protocol controller? Okay, for CAN network, every node requires CAN controller. It can be internal or it can be external. Okay, if the microcontroller doesn't have inbuilt CAN controller, so it can be interfaced with the external CAN controller. Okay, so same goes with the Flexray also. Flexray also require a Flexray controller, which basically runs the protocol part. Same with the CAN also. CAN controller also runs the CAN protocol part. So Flexray controller runs the Flexray protocol part. Data bytes, okay. So in a CAN frame, maximum of 8 bytes can be sent, whereas in Flexray, which is much more than CAN, maximum of 254 bytes can be sent. So this is one of the advantage of using the Flexray. So Flexray has Flexray is 10 times faster than CAN, as well as, okay, look at the types of frames. Okay, CAN has 4 types of frame formats: data frame, remote frame, error frame and overload frame. The data frame is used to send the data, whereas remote frame is used to request the data. Error frame is used to send the or indicate the error on the bus. And overload frame is used for the slower nodes. Flexray also has 4 different cycle variants of frame. Now you look at the picture. So you have 4 different the cycle variants. Okay, variant A, where you have a static segment and you have a network idle time. Okay, variant B, where you have a static segment and you have optional dynamic segment and network idle time. Okay, and variant C, where you have a static segment, dynamic segment, symbol window and network idle time. This is the third variant. So in the last variant, where you can see the static segment, symbol window and network idle time. Okay, so the static segment and network idle time, they are mandatory, whereas dynamic segment and symbol window, they are optional. Okay, if any node has any message to be sent, it can make use of a dynamic segment. If doesn't have, then it's optional. Okay, what about the CRC, cyclic redundancy check? Okay, CAN has a 15 bit CRC sequence followed by a 1 CRC delimit. Both the transmitters and the receivers will use a predefined polynomial, so hence they can easily check the CRC. Flexray has 2 CRCs within a frame. Okay, the CRC of 11 bit at the header, and also it has got a CRC of 24 bit at the trailer. If you want to know some more details about Flexray frame format, please do subscribe to my channel, and very shortly I am going to upload some more videos on Flexray protocol. Okay, bus guardian. So bus guardian, basically in CAN you don't have any bus guardian, whereas in Flexray you have a bus guardian. Because CAN has an excellent error detection and the handling mechanism at the protocol level, but it does not have a bus guardian. Flexray has a bus guardian because there is a static segment where every node is assigned a slot to transmit the data. But if some node unknowingly or accidentally sends the data during the not allocated slot, then it could be a collision, so which is very difficult to avoid. That is the reason there is a bus guardian which will only allow the nodes to transmit data during the scheduled time. So the data is located in a reserved slot in a static communication segment. Okay, so within a dynamic segment this is not required, because they compute for the bus and the arbitration takes place and the bus is allocated. Okay, some of the similarities between CAN and Flexray. So both are serial communication protocol, both uses a differential voltage logic, both requires transceivers for voltage conversion.